to a new episode by Flyboys Aviation. This episode is about the troubled beginnings of the McDonnell Douglas DC-10. The legendary Tri-Hola was a trusted sign at airports around the world in the late 20th century. The first few years of service of this aircraft were very problematic, however. What were the causes? Did the DC-10 ever recover? Let's take a look at this together. The first flight of the McDonnell Douglas DC-10 was in 1970. It was fitted with three engines, which was the minimum for overwater flights in those days. Its main competitor was the Lockheed L-1011 TriStar, which first flew 9 months later. The DC-10 entered commercial service with American Airlines on a round trip from Chicago to Los Angeles. In order to carry the maximum amount of cargo, the DC-10 had outward opening cargo doors. In that way, the amount of cargo space would not be limited by doors that opened inwards. The cargo doors had a design flaw, however. It was possible to close the outside lever without the hooks that held the door in place fully engaged. Due to this very flaw, the cargo door on American Airlines Flight 96 blew open during flight. Miraculously, the aircraft made it back safely. No airworthiness directive was issued by the FAA after the investigation into this incident. This was due to a gentleman's agreement between the heads of the FAA and McDonnell Douglas. Sadly, Turkish Airlines Flight 981 crashed outside Paris in 1974 because of this very cargo door problem. It turned out McDonnell Douglas had known about the problem during development. During pressure tests, the cargo doors had failed. McDonnell Douglas chose to ignore this, however. This time, an airworthiness directive was issued to all airlines flying the DC-10. It ended the problems related to the cargo doors of this aircraft. Then, in 1979, American Airlines Flight 191 crashed after the number one engine had separated from the aircraft. American Airlines had removed the engine and pylon during routine maintenance. They removed the engine and pylon as a single unit instead of separately, as was advised by McDonnell Douglas. The forklift they used for this procedure was placed incorrectly. As a result of this, the engine pylon was damaged. This caused metal fatigue that slowly developed until Flight 191. The FAA suspended the type certificate of the DC-10 2 weeks after the crash. This resulted in a temporary worldwide grounding of the DC-10. The aircraft's reputation suffered heavily because of this. In the decades after this, it went on to achieve a safety record comparable to similar generation airliners. Nowadays, it can still occasionally be seen flying cargo. With its unique shape, it is a perennial favorite among aviation enthusiasts. What do you guys think? Who was to blame for the problems of the DC-10? Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. On my channel, you will find a new video every week that delves deeper into the fascinating world of aviation and offers you new insights. See you around!